Lakers were led by Anthony Davis's 37 points last night, but it was LeBron who stole the show. Just minutes into the third quarter, LeBron pulled up and drained a 36-foot three-pointer from the R inside the Lakers logo at half court. And after the game, LeBron said it's something he works on a lot. When asked if it was a good shot to take, Frank Vogel said, quote, when it goes in, it's a good one. And if it doesn't go in, it's a bad one. It's easy, easy. Coaching here.
Yeah, it is.
It's easy to say don't when coach. It goes in.
Go ahead. You don't have to coach. Stop that.
There might be more to that. There might be more to that. Now joined by Fox Sports NBA analyst Chris Broussard. Good morning.
Good morning.
In your opinion, LeBron taking 36-footers, good thing or bad thing?
I think it's a good thing, and I don't know exactly what Skip's going to say, but
yeah,
I think I know. The only potential downfall is if LeBron made this, or even a 26-footer, right, his go-to shot in the clutch. And I don't think, I think he's too smart to do that. I want his go-to shot to be that post-up, back-down, fade-away, turn-around.
That when it hit on Jaylen Brown?
Yes, oh, yes. Yeah. Do that on Kawhi.
How about wheel and attack the glass? How about that shot?
You can do that, but I think he's perfecting the fade-away a little better. So I hope that becomes his go-to shot. We'll see this weekend. I can't wait till Sunday. But anyway, I think LeBron's too smart to just start settling for shots like this. Now, I love it for so many other reasons. One is the wow factor. You know, I've been covering the game, you even longer than me, but 25 years, there's very few things that make me jump off my seat. Like, what? Like, it's usually if you dunk on somebody really well, and LeBron's had some of those these years. But the 36-footer from the logo, when you see Trey do it, Trey Young, Damian Lillard, Steph Curry, it's really, it's great then. But to see a 6'9", 260-pounder pull up like a regular jumper and do it, that is great for the wow factor. I'm also going to say this. And you know, Skip, I believe Jordan is the GOAT. And there's very little in my mind realistically that LeBron can do to surpass him. But I've said it before, and I'll say it again. In 10 to 15 years, when the millennials are controlling the narrative, when we're not controlling the narrative anymore, it's going to, I think LeBron's going to be recognized as the GOAT because they're going to control the narrative. And the things like this, even though this is a rarity, they will point to things like this and highlight. These will be highlights where they'll say, look at his range. He adapted to the game. He became a great shooter and things like that. And then I will say there is a little strategy to it in the playoffs or in a regular game, but let's say the playoffs. If teams, like say he hits three more before the end of the season, and teams really start to fear that he could do that.
Nobody's going to fear it, but go ahead.
Now, though, they may have to pick you up higher, and that will open things up for Anthony Davis and space the floor even more. So, I love it. I thought it's tremendous.
Yeah, love it.
You think he's going to start shooting five of these a game?
Also, open things up for 2 for 13 for 3 playoff games. Thank you very much.
How fair would it be if Tom Brady had Lamar Jackson's speed? His ability to throw the football, his ability to read and react with Lamar Jackson's speed.
He doesn't need it.
Okay, then.
He's won 6 out of 9 Super Bowls.
LeBron James don't need to be able to hit a 40-foot jumper when you can come downhill better than anybody in the history of the game. But, ooh, but he got it. See, the difference is Tom Brady is never going to have Lamar Jackson's speed. But my guy can hit them jumpers like Logo Lillard. No, not he Logo LeBron. Now, I don't know if you know this, Skip Bayless, but we spend $700 billion a year on our military. And they don't have equipment that has this kind of range.
Really?
And this kind of accuracy.
Really?
And for $700 billion. And the Lakers got that for $35 million. And they got it for 2 more years.
Wow.
So, Skip Bayless... this is what I want to know. Because here's the thing. Let me tell you why LeBron's doing this. He keeps hearing everybody say, Giannis is the runaway MVP. Kawhi is the best player. Zion got next. Oh, go Jackson said, bam, bam, bam. Sunday night and last night. Hey, y'all do know I'm here. Y'all talking, y'all having this conversation, and I'm right here. I ain't going anywhere. I told you, I'm still the GOAT. Goat James. That's why he's doing it. Skip, look, if you plead black enough, and what is he supposed to do? You say, well, drive the ball. Skip, they... See, unlike Giannis, Giannis can't do this. See, they build that forward up for LeBron. LeBron says, okay, stand back there.
This is really sick. And I mean sick bad. Is it my turn now?
It's yours.
I want to hear this.
Millennials, wake up. There's a shot in basketball called a free throw because it's free. It is an unguarded 15-foot shot. And LeBron says he's now working on his 40-foot shot, and he can't consistently make an unguarded shot from 15 feet, especially with the money on the line. That's what we're up against here, is that I had to sit and listen to LeBron after the game say, I'm working on all parts. I'm growing my game because I want to have no weaknesses.
Done.
He's a lousy free throw shooter. He's left thousands of points on the table over his career, cost his team because he's such a lousy free throw shooter. And now you're telling me he's perfecting a 40-foot shot that he might make 20% of if he's lucky. If he's lucky. It's a bad shot, especially for him, because he's not even a good three-point shooter. The numbers don't lie. They just scream, no, no, no. And he's still doing that because of the wow factor. He's building his brand. And I give you that. He's great at that, especially if he can make a couple. If he can make a couple of more down the stretch.
He will.
It will blow away the internet because the internet just lives for that kind of shot. And I told this man earlier, the irony here is, he shoots that shot with far more confidence than he shoots free throws. And that's the God's truth. He goes up into that shot because there's no pressure on that shot because he knows if he misses, nobody's going to hold him accountable. He's not going to get yanked from the game by Frank Vogel.
Won't yell at him.
He won't yell at him. Stop it. And that's pretty to me. That was great form, and he shot it with conviction and with great strength because it's hard to shoot a jump shot from 40 feet or whatever it is from the logo. It's hard to even get
40.
It.
They keep saying 36.
I know, it's 36.
Right. And the one in New Orleans looked farther than that one.
Okay, right. But it's just, yeah. I'm impressed you can even get it to the front of the rim, let alone over the rim, from that far as a jump shot. Now, if you just step into it and shoot a running set shot, right. I got you.
Right.
You know,
right.
That's not like Luka shot sort of a set shot from half court the other night and hit the front of the rim at the buzzer in Chicago. Remember
right.
that?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so he's shooting that with confidence because there's no pressure. But just to frame this for all those millennials out there, just look what's happening right now. LeBron's at 35% from three. Remember, that doesn't count four. It only counts three, right? So he's 14 feet behind the three-point line. You can go put your toes all the way up to the edge of the line,
yeah.
And it's still just counts.
What's the fun
three,
in
right?
that?
Okay, what's the fun in that? So remember, 50 players have attempted at least 300 threes so far this NBA season. 50. LeBron is fourth worst at 35%. And the guys below him are only one tick below him, and it's Josh Hart, who, by the way, went 1-for-9 last night in the home game, and Covington and Taurean Prince. You know, these are just guys who don't shoot the three very well, and that's his company as a three-point shooter.
But we...
Look at the free throws. He's at 69.3. So there are 23 who are high-volume free throw shooters, 300 or more free throws. He's fifth worst on that list because he's a lousy free throw shooter. So at practice, does he stay after and shoot 100 free throws?
Yeah.
Or does he stay after and shoot 100 logos? I don't know.
Well, that's the thing. I see, if he weren't working on the free throws, then I'd agree with
him. I don't know.
I think he's working on them.
Work.
And I do agree. Look, we all know LeBron is a thinker. And sometimes when you're a thinker, you can overanalyze and get in your mind. I've talked to him about this in the past. He is able to hit incredible shots oftentimes because you're not thinking. You're just throw it up, you know, reacting, kind of like you said. But I do think at the free throw line, it's I think it's in his head. When you get a shot like that,
you have to stop and you have to think about more. What's my routine? Am I going to step back before I shoot? How am I going to do it tonight?
Okay.
And he gets a little shaky-handed. And with that shot, that's pure.
Well, let me tell you what was shaky, Skip Bayless. On deep threes by the league average, and this means you shoot 40 shots or more. In 2017-18, he was 23 of 44.
What's a deep three? What's considered a deep three?
I guess considering past 27, because the farthest is the arc is 27, yes.
Okay.
Skip, he was 23 of 42.
So what are we 40. Talking about, like 30 foot or more?
Yeah.
So he may shoot, so he shoots deep threes better than the closer threes.
The higher degree That's of random. Difficulty, the better he is.
Yeah.
That goes with my theory that he's not thinking with no pressure.
That's what, like, but see, that's what great LaGaine is. Anybody can do for you in the lead, but when he was behind, you remember, Skip, when he hit his head? You remember when Greg Louganis hit his head? It's like, oh, it's over. His streak is over. Somebody's going to beat Greg Louganis in an Olympics. Uh-uh. Mm. When the money need to be, when the money get on the table.
It's impressive.
It's impressive.
It's impressive.
So all I know is I can't get out of my head the 2013 and 2014 NBA Finals in which the Bill Belichick of NBA coaches, Greg Popovich, is waving his defenders, literally waving them off LeBron. Just let him shoot the three. Let him shoot it. And, of course, it went all the way down to the last shot of Game 6, or so I thought, and he LeBricks it from three. And long rebound, Chris Bosh kicks it to Ray Allen, and you know the rest of the story.
He wasn't as good of a shooter back then, though. And I'm not saying he's a great shooter, but he's a better shooter now.
Why would you weaken your strength? Because he's still, to this moment, he's the greatest driver of the basketball I have ever seen, and he's still the best driver of the ball in the league today.
And
why wouldn't you just exploit that? He destroyed the Pelicans just low posting, and he made one fadeaway, but he made a bunch of spins and just...
Hold on, Skip Bayless. If you don't know... Hold on. You add. Popeyes could have been perfectly fine just making fried chicken, but they came with a chicken sandwich and they swept the nation.
Really?
So LeBron James could have been perfectly content driving the basketball, Chris, but he added this shot, and now he's unguardable.
He's showing, he's in his bag,
I thought you were
going to
talk about Popeye with spinach. I thought you were going to tell me Popeye added broccoli or something.
No, no.
Right?
You're talking about sandwich.
So now he added this?
Yeah.
Huh?
You got it, Biscuit. You're impressed.
Look, I dare him. If I'm coaching against him, I'm like, please shoot those.